Guys, what's up? So it is a new month, so please enroll in this course by clicking on enroll button, or you watch 3 videos and you will be automatically enrolled. This is based on the 1st March 2017 current affairs, and these are the 10 MCQs which I'll be making on daily basis, and the instructions are pretty clear. Please watch the Hindu summary and editorial analysis on anacademy.com, and as soon as the question appears, pause the video, answer the question and resume it 100% of the time without fail. Please calculate your score, write it in the comment section so that you can compete not only with yourself but with others as well. And if you are getting 8 or more, then you have very high chance of selection in this year prelims. Question number 1, with regard to C. Mai Karuvelam, that is Prosopis julifera, consider the following statements. It is a native medicinal tree species used in the manufacture of India's first anti-diabetic Ayurvedic drug. Okay, this is wrong. It reproduces by way of seeds dispersed mainly by animals, consuming the seed pods and spreading it through droppings. So this is correct. Answer is D, that is 2 only. So C. Mai Karuvelam or Prosopis julifera is an invasive tree species that is attributed with huge environmental damage. They are also called as exotic species, as it inhibits the growth of indigenous plants. A non-native species, which means exotic species, it was brought to India during the colonial period for its utility as firewood and for erecting fences. Now, late in 1960s, aerial seeding of the plant was carried out in dry lands of southern Tamil Nadu to overcome firewood shortage. And statement 2 is correct, as the plant reproduces by way of seeds dispersed mainly through animals by the process of endozoochory, that is dispersal via ingestion by vertebrate animals. So you can be asked this term. Which of the following parties are signatories to Indus Water Treaty of 1960? Here the answer is India, Pakistan and the World Bank. So many people confuse, the World Bank is not there, but it is there. So answer is 1, 3 and 5, so C. So the Indus Treaty, Water Treaty, was brokered by World Bank International, that is also called as International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, and therefore it is a neutral signatory to the agreement. The water sharing accord is between India and Pakistan, signed at Karachi in 1960 under the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru and Ayub Khan of Pakistan. This is very important, please remember this. The eastern rivers, since India is in east of Pakistan, so all the eastern rivers belong to India, that is Satluj, Bias and Ravi. They shall be available for unrestricted use by India, while the western rivers, that is Jhelum, Chenab and Indus, are left for Pakistan. Question number 3, consider the following statements on the temperature of the sun. The temperature at the sun's surface photosphere is about 5500 degrees Celsius, almost the same as the temperature of the earth's inner core. The sun's atmosphere corona is not as hot as the photosphere. Select the correct statement using below. The first statement is correct, second is wrong. Answer is B, that is 1 only. So statement 1 is correct. The temperature at the surface of the sun called as photosphere is about 5500 degrees Celsius. And this is almost the same as the temperature of Earth's inner core, that ranges from 3000 to 6600 degrees Celsius. Statement 2 is incorrect, as the temperature at sun's corona, its atmosphere, is a sizzling 2 million degrees Celsius. This is puzzling, as we may think the farther from the heat source, the lesser the temperature. Then NASA has revealed its plan to send a robotic spacecraft next year to probe the sun's atmosphere, which may possibly find an explanation for this puzzling phenomena, but obviously it needs to be heat resistant, otherwise it will just melt away. Question number 4, Bosnia and Herzegovina is pretty much a landlocked country except for a small strip of land extending just 20 kilometers that provides coastline access to which of the following sea? Here the answer is C, that is they provide the access to Adriatic Sea. So I'll show you the map so you'll know the exact location. So this is Bosnia and Herzegovina, this is Croatia, capital is Zagreb, this is Slovenia, this is Italy, this is Serbia, and here is which sea? Please tell me this sea. So this is Adriatic Sea, so they can ask you who borders Adriatic Sea. Answer will be Italy, Slovenia, Croatia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Montenegro, and so on and so forth. So Adriatic Sea separates the Italian peninsula from the Balkan peninsula in southern Europe. It's a very important concept, we need to know this. Question number 5, consider the following statements on Amarnath Cave Temple. Devotees make an annual pilgrimage to the temple during the festival of Shravani Mela in July and August. Okay. The Shiva Linga inside that cave temple is basically an ice stalactite formation. So here the answer is B, that is 1 only. Statement 1 is correct. The annual pilgrimage to the Amarnath temple in Jammu and Kashmir takes place during the 45-day festive period of Shravani Mela in July to August, which coincides with the Hindu holy month of Shravan. Theek hai bhai, hamara, it's a holy month. And statement 2 is incorrect, as the shivling of the temple is an ice stalagmite. Okay, so just remember that, because it rises from the floor of the cave. So that is an important concept. You need to differentiate these two. And the stalactite formations on the other end hang down from the ceiling of the cave. So whatever hangs down from the cave, it's called a stalactite. But if something rises from the floor of the cave, it's called a stalagmite. Okay, make some mnemonic for this. Question number 6. Which of the following statements regarding advance pricing agreements signed by the Central Board of Direct Taxes are correct? They are ahead of time agreements that specify methods of pricing and prices of international transactions in the domain of transfer pricing. 100% correct. They provide clarity and certainty to taxpayers, fostering a non-adversarial tax regime. This is also 100% correct. They can be either unilateral or bilateral. This is also 100% correct. Answer is D, that is 1, 2 and 3. So, advance pricing agreements or APAs introduced in the Income Tax Act in 2012 endeavors to provide certainty to taxpayers in the domain of transfer pricing by specifying the methods of pricing and setting the prices of international transactions in advance. Transfer pricing, on the other hand, refers to taxation methods and policies transactions within enterprises involving trade of surpluses or labors. And as a part of government's initiative to foster a non-adversarial tax regime, the APAs signed by CBDT are appreciated for being able to address complex transfer pricing issues in a fair and transparent manner. Question number 7. Which of the following best explain the term nematodes that were on the news recently? So nematodes are basically worms, so everybody should know about them. So they are microscopic pests that attack crops, resulting in huge crop loss. So this is the closest thing that resembles them. Answer is B. So nematodes are the microscopic worms consisting of roundworms, threadworms, eelworms, many of which are parasites. And they had recently emerged as a major threat to crops in India, as they cause a loss of 60 million tons of crops annually. Do you know how many millions of people can feed on that? According to ICAR, that is Indian Council of Agricultural Research, such large scale crop loss is also having an adverse effect on the agricultural biosafety, that is paramount to food security. Question number 8. With regard to the congenital rubella syndrome CRS, consider the following statements. Rubella is a highly infectious and killer disease among children. Okay. Rubella virus may be transmitted from an infected woman to her fetus during pregnancy. This is 100% correct. Rubella virus can cause hearing impairments, eye and heart defects, brain damage in newborns. 100% correct. India has set an ambitious target of eliminating congenital rubella syndrome by 2020. This is wrong. First is also wrong. So answer is 2 and 3, that is C. So statement 1 is incorrect. Rubella is a very mild viral infection that occurs mainly among children, while measles is highly infectious and a childhood killer. Okay, that caused an estimate 47,000 deaths in India. Rubella virus has a 90% chance of being transmitted to the fetus from the infected mother, and the virus can cause hearing impairments, eyes and ears, heart defects, brain damage in newborns, and even spontaneous abortion and fetal deaths. And an estimated 40,000 cases of children born with CRS occurs in India. Now, statement 4 is also incorrect, as India does not aim to eliminate congenital rubella syndrome completely by 2020. Its target is to control CRS and eliminate measles by 2020. Question number 9. Which of the following statements on tortoises and freshwater turtles are correct? Turtles are integral to a healthy riverine system, as they act as scavengers cleaning up water bodies. And National Mission for Clean Ganga envisages breeding and release of turtles to clean wetlands. The answer is both 1 and 2 here. So tortoises and freshwater turtles are poached from Gangetic regions known for its diversity of TFT population along the river. Illegal trade of the poached TFTs are rampant for domestic meat consumption and international export. And turtles, they form an important part of the riverine system, which act as scavengers in cleaning up water bodies and generally being indicators of river health. So it is an important concept. And National Mission for Clean Ganga envisages breeding and release of turtles to clean wetlands, although poaching and trade continues across the Gangetic belt. And river systems of Western Ghats also have considerable population of TFTs. Last question for the day is, consider the following statements on Bandhan Financial Services. It is the country's largest MFI. Yes. It also undertakes regular banking activities as a commercial bank through its subsidiary. Yes. A majority of its customers are women. This is also correct. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3. So Bandhan Financial Services was started in 2001 as a microfinance company in West Bengal. It provides microfinance services to women who are socially disadvantaged and economically exploited. And it is the largest microfinance organization in India. And it received banking license from RBI in 2014, and therefore it offers traditional banking services through its subsidiary called as Bandhan Bank. So everything is important, and thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day. Do enroll in the course. Guys, what's up? So as promised, I am back with my MCQ videos, and this is expected MCQs for UPSC CSE prelims 2017, and they will be based on the 2nd March 2017 current affairs. Please enroll in this course and download our Android app, so whenever I make this lesson, you'll get a notification. Instructions are pretty clear, so you can just follow them. Question number 1, with regard to ochre colored pottery culture, consider the following statements. It is roughly placed between 2000 and 1800 BC, concentrated to the Ganga Yamuna Doab. The OCP culture discoveries validate the people are likely to be one of the earliest primitive agriculturalists and artisans who led a settled life in the Ganga Yamuna Doab region. The bronze using OCP culture is placed as a contemporary to copper using Harappan culture. Select the correct statements from that. Answer is B, that is 1 and 2, the third is wrong. So statement 1 and 2 are correct. The ochre colored pottery culture settlements and copper hoards comprising of axes, harpoons, antenna swords for hunting, fighting, agricultural use, and the discovery of ochre colored pots and mud structures additionally means that the people had a settled life, one of the earliest primitive agriculturalists and artisans to settle in the Ganga Yamuna Doab region. Doab means where two rivers follow. Punjab means where five rivers flow. Okay, Do means two, Ab means, you got the point, right? Statement 3 is incorrect, as the OCP people are copper hoarders, unlike their bronze using contemporaries of the Harappan region. So that is why the third statement is wrong. Question number 2, which of the following are prominent genome editing techniques? Here the answer is CRISPR is definitely there. I introduced it yesterday also in a question. Zinc finger nuclease is definitely there. TALEN is also there. TALEN is transcription activator like effector nucleases. Scanning force microscopy is definitely not there, so answer is 1, 2 and 4. That is C is the answer here correctly. So solution is CRISPR is clustered regulatory interspaced short palindromic repeats. It was on the news recently. It is one of the most prominent genome editing technique. So by editing genome, you can accomplish a lot of things. You can make drugs, insulin, whatnot. And zinc finger nucleus and transcriptor activator like effector nucleus, TALEN. They are the other two tools to edit sequence of DNA, and scanning force microscopy SFM is related to nanotechnology. That is a device used for visualizing, imaging, taking measures and for manipulating objects that are in nanometer scales. Question number 3, the Strait of Hormuz, that was on the news recently, connects which of the two water bodies? So it connects Gulf of Oman and Persian Gulf. So the Strait of Hormuz is the only sea passage connecting Persian Gulf to the Arabian Sea and open. So can you see, this is Persian Gulf, this is Arabian Sea, okay, and this here you can see that, okay. So it connects your Gulf of Oman and Persian Gulf. So this is Gulf of Oman, this is Persian Gulf, this is Strait of Hormuz, and it is one of the world's most strategically important choke points, especially during the previous confrontation between US and Iran. And nearly a third of all oil trade by sea passes through this strait. So you can realize the importance when all the oil is passing through this. It becomes very, very important. Question number 4. Consider the following statements on East African Community. It is an intergovernmental organization that consists of 6 nations in the African Great Lakes Rift Valley region. It is Africa's largest free trade zone. Which of the following is correct? First is correct, second is wrong. So statement 1 is correct, that East African Community consists of Burundi, Kenya, Rwanda, South Sudan, Tanzania and Uganda, all surrounding the Lake Victoria in Eastern Africa. Lake Victoria, however, is not a part of the African Rift Valley system. And statement 2 is incorrect. Africa's largest free trade zone is not this, but tripartite free trade area. It is a union of 3 trade blocs, including EAC. EAC is just one member. The other two members include SADC and COMESA. Tripartite means 3 parties, so it includes EAC, okay, SADC and COMESA. Question number 5, which of the following statements are Swachh Shakti Saptah program are correct? Okay, it is a week-long program across the nation to honor the role of women in Swachh Bharat mission. It is launched by Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. Select the correct codes. Both of them are absolutely correct. So on March 1, 2017, the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation launched the nationwide Swachh Shakti Saptah to underline women's role in Swachh Bharat mission. And nationwide events honoring women champions, women sarpanches, ASHA workers, accredited social health activists, school teachers, young students, senior citizens involved in the Swachh Bharat mission are planned as part of this program. And finally, it will culminate with a mega event in Gujarat named Swachh Shakti 2017. Question number 6, with regards to Project Elephant, consider the following statements. It is a statutory agency set up in accordance to Wildlife Protection Act of 1991. It assists states having free-ranging wild elephant population to protect their habitat and corridors. It does not give attention to mitigation of man-animal conflicts in elephant habitats, one of the strong criticisms of the project. Here the C is the only, that is the 2 is the only correct option. Answer is C, that is 2 only. So Project Elephant is a centrally sponsored scheme that offer financial and technical assistance to states having elephant population. Therefore, statement 1 is incorrect, absolutely incorrect. Statement 3 is also incorrect. The scheme does include addressing the issues of man-animal conflict as its key objectives, and it moderates the pressure of human and domestic stock activities in key elephant habitats. Question number 7, subsidies related to public stock holding in WTO refers to which one of the following? Here answer is D, subsidies given through MSP to farmers in order to procure food grains for distribution. Okay, so that is the correct option. So at the WTO, the developed countries were criticizing India for offering higher subsidies related to public stock holding, like minimum support prices for food grains. They claim that these subsidies will distort trade, which does against the key objective of WTO. But that is not the case. It is a wrong thing. Question number 8. Select the correct statements on the lion capital of Sarnath. It symbolizes Dharm Chakra Pravartan, which is considered as Buddha's first sermon. The capital with the crowning wheel and inverted lotus base in the national emblem of India. Okay. So select the correct codes on this. So the answer here is A, that is 1 only. So only the first statement is correct. The first sermon of Buddha took place at Sarnath. So second statement is wrong. The capital includes 5 major components: shaft, broken lotus bell base, drum on the bell base with 4 animal proceeding clockwise, 4 lion figures and crowning elements, which is the Dharm Chakra. Statement 2 is incorrect, as the national emblem of India is a lion capital without the crowning wheel and the lotus base. So this is an important differentiating factor which every Indian should know. Question number 9, consider the following statements on the functions of SEBI, that is Securities Exchange Board of India. It prohibits fraudulent and unfair trade practices like price rigging. So they can ask you also, 6 years back, UK Sinha was the chairman, that is why it is in news. So you can remember his name, Upendra Kumar Sinha, 1976 IAS officer. It trains intermediaries and educate investors. It registers and regulates stockbrokers, merchant bankers and share transfer agents. Select the correct code. All the following are absolutely correct. Answer is D123. So all the statements are correct. The functions of SEBI can be broadly classified as protective, developmental and regulatory functions. Statement 1 is a protective function with the objective of safeguarding the interest of investors and safety of investments. Statement 2 is a developmental function, and statement 3 is a regulatory function where it registers and formulates code of conduct for intermediaries, merchant bankers and underwriters. And last question for the day is, consider the following statements on Pawan Hans Helicopter Services in India. It is a public sector undertaking that falls under Mini Ratna 1 category. It is a national helicopter company established for providing services in remote areas only. A considerable amount of stakes in the government enterprise is with Air India. Select the following codes. Which of the following is correct? Answer is only the first statement is correct, because ONGC owns a considerable 49% stake in the enterprise, is not Air India. So third statement is wrong. And Pawan Hans supports services in remote areas in oil sector for offshore exploration operation and promotion of tourism. So this is wrong, and because only word is there. So only the first statement is correct. Answer is B, 1 only. So established in 1985, Pawan Hans is a Mini Ratna 1 category PSU, that is public sector undertaking. Pawan Hans supports services in remote areas in oil sector for offshore exploration, operations, promotion of tourism, and ONGC owns a considerable 49% stake in the enterprises. So thank you for watching this lesson. Do enroll in this course and do download our Android app on Play Store. And thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day. Hey guys, what's up? So please enroll in this course if you have not done already, and download our Android app so that you get the notification whenever you watch this, whenever I add a new lesson to this course. And this is the MCQs based on the 3rd March 2017 current affairs, presented by me, obviously Roman Saini. Instructions are pretty clear, so you can follow them. Question number 1, with regard to World Wildlife Day, consider the following statements. It was declared as a day of importance by World Wildlife Fund. It is observed in March 3, the day of signature of the CITES, that is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora. Select the correct statement using the code below. See, first statement is wrong, second statement is correct. Answer is B, 2 only. So World Wildlife Day was declared by United Nations General Assembly on its 68th session in December 2013 to celebrate and raise awareness of the world's wild fauna and flora. Statement 2 is correct. As the day honors the adoption on CITES, that is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, on March 3, 1973. And the theme for this year on World Wildlife Day celebration is Listen to the Young Voices. And World Wildlife Day 2017 encourages youth around the world to rally together to address ongoing major threats to wildlife, including habitat change, over-exploitation, illicit trafficking, etc. Question number 2, which of the following activities are being financed from the Clean Ganga Fund, CGF? Activities under the Namami Ganga program: conservation of the biotic diversity of the river, promotion and development of National Waterway 1 on the Ganga River, setting up of waste treatment and disposal plants along the river around the cities. Which of the following statement is correct? Answer is C, 1, 2 and 4. Third statement is wrong. So the Clean Ganga Fund is managed by a trust under Union Finance Minister and accepts voluntary contribution from citizens, NRIs, etc. And the Clean Ganga Fund will finance the following 8 broad activities. Activities outlined under the Namami Ganga program for cleaning of River Ganga: control of non-point pollution from agricultural runoff, human defecation and cattle wallowing, setting up of waste treatment and disposal plants along the river around the cities, conservation of the biotic diversity of the river, community-based activities to reduce polluting human interface with the river, development of public amenities including activities such as ghat redevelopment, research and development and innovative projects, research and development projects and innovative projects for new technology and processes for cleaning the river, independent oversight through intensive monitoring and real-time reporting. Question number 3, select the following statements about the tributaries of the river Indus. Satluj is the easternmost tributary of Indus, 100% correct. Bias unites with Satluj, this is also correct. Jhelum and Ravi joins the Chenab River, this is also correct. And Chenab joins the river Satluj. Which of the following statement is correct? All the 4 statements are absolutely correct. Answer is D. Question number 4, which of the following are published by World Bank, that is International Bank for Reconstruction and Development? World Logistics Performance Index, yes. World Development Report, yes. Ease of Doing Business Report, yes. Global Economic Prospects Report, yes. So technically all the 4 are published by World Bank. So World Bank or IBRD is persistently on the news this week, and all the 4 mentioned reports are published by World Bank. Question number 5, which of the following statements on National Skill Development Corporation are correct? It is a public-private partnership venture with significant operational and financial involvement from the private sector. It is a part of National Skill Development Mission under Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. It provides funding to enterprises, companies and organizations that provide skill training. So all the three statements are correct. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3. So National Skill Development Corporation, it was announced in 2008-2009 budget as a world-class skill development program in a mission mode that will address the challenge of imparting the skills required by a growing economy. And it is a not-for-profit company set up as a part of National Skill Development Mission under Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. And it has an equity base of rupees 10 crore, of which the Government of India holds for 49%, while the private sector has the balance 51%. Question number 6, which of the following regions are identified as potential shale gas reserves in India? Krishna, Godavari Basin, Kaveri Basin, Greater Andaman, Gulf of Mannar, Cambay. Answer is 1, 2 and 5, that is Krishna, Godavari Basin, Kaveri Basin and Cambay. Greater Andaman and Gulf of Mannar are not the answer. Answer is B, 1, 2, 5. So Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas has identified 6 major regions of shale gas reserves in India. Krishna Godavari Basin, Indo-Gangetic Basin, it includes the Damodar Basin, Cambay is in Gujarat, Kaveri Basin, Assam, Arakan Basin and Gondwana region in Central India. Question number 7, which of the following statements on Tara Tarini Hill Shrine in Ganjam district of Orissa are correct? Tara Tarini was the traditional patron deities for sailors and merchants of ancient Odisha. Yes, it is located on the Kumari Hills on the banks of Rushikulya River, yes. The shrine has ancient links to Mahayan Buddhism, but later it became a shrine of tantrism. All the 3 statements are correct. So answer is D. So Tara Tarini Hill Shrine is frequently in the news in recent times. So the region was an active Buddhist site as per the Jokhada rock edicts of Ashoka, 4 kilometers away from the shrine. And Tara is an important deity of Mahayan Buddhist pantheon. Therefore, ancient Buddhist influence is evident. And in the later period, the shrine became associated with Adi Shakti or Shaktism, which is a sub-tradition of Tantric Hinduism. It's an important concept. Question number 8, select the following statements on Kaziranga National Park. So let us consider these statements about Kaziranga National Park. It hosts 2/3 of world one horned rhinoceros population in India. Okay, so this statement is correct. It is a tiger reserve. Again, it is correct. It is one among the World Net of Biosphere Reserves under UNESCO, and it is declared as important bird and biodiversity area by Wildlife International. Third statement is wrong. First is correct, second is correct, fourth is correct. Answer is C 1 to 4. So Kaziranga National Park, which is on the news, is both a tiger reserve and an important bird and biodiversity area IBA, and it is located in Assam. It hosts one horned rhinoceros, which is IUCN status of vulnerable, in large numbers. And statement 3 is incorrect. There are 10 World Net of Biosphere Reserves in India under UNESCO's Man and Biosphere Initiative, and latest one being added is Agastyamalai in Western Ghats. Question number 9. During the upcoming monsoon of 2017, the first controlled experiment on cloud seeding using silver iodide over clouds hovering over Solapur, Maharashtra will be conducted. In this regard, consider the following statements. The technique alters the microphysical processes within the cloud by dispersing substances that can act as condensation nuclei, and this is also used to suppress hail and fog or wear away rain from a particular place. Which of the following statement is correct? Answer is C, that is both 1 and 2 statements are correct. So both these statements are correct here, and the weather modification technique is also widely practiced in places like airports or open event venues to wear away rainfall or suppress hail and fog. And last question for the day is, Indo-Israeli Agricultural Cooperation Project is on the news in recent times. In this regard, consider the following statements. It involves training and technology transfers to Indian farmers on irrigation techniques, water management, nursery production and post-harvest management. Yes, Agricultural Centers of Excellence has been established under the cooperation agreement to achieve its objectives. Yes, it involves long-term financial loans and packages for Indian farmers. No, answer is D, 1 and 2 only. So, Indo-Israeli Agricultural Cooperation Project was born out of a bilateral agreement in 2006 between India and Israel, and the project is implemented by MIDH, that is Mission for Integrated Development of Horticulture, and MASHOV, which is an Israeli agency for international development cooperation under the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and its primary goals include increasing crop diversity, increasing productivity and increasing resources use efficiency. And new agricultural centers of excellence are likely to be set up in the states of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day. Please enroll in the course and download our Android app. Guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs based on the 4th March 2017 current affairs. And this is presented by me, Roman Saini. So let's get started. The instructions are pretty clear and you can follow them here. Question number 1. Kuruk was on the news recently. Which of the following statement given below aptly describes the term? So Kuruk is basically an endangered tribal language of Dravidian family. So the major languages of Dravidian family kaun si hoti hain? The four: Andhra Pradesh ki Telugu, Telangana Telugu, then you have Karnataka Kannada, then you have Tamil Nadu Tamil, and Kerala Malayalam. So these are the four famous languages in Dravidian family. There are other languages also. Kuruk is one of them. So Kuruk language is spoken by Oraon tribe and has been given official status in the state of West Bengal, and it is of Dravidian origin, unlike most other tribal languages of the region, which are either Austroasiatic or Tibeto-Burman in origin. And the script of the Kuruk language is Tolong Sikhi, which reflects the socio-cultural aspect of the tribal community. Question number 2. Which of the following statements regarding the recently launched roll-on, roll-off services is or are correct? So it is an initiative by Indian Railways to reduce carbon emission and congestion on the roads of the National Capital Region. Yes, this is 100% correct. The project employs next generation electric high speed train sets that does not need a separate locomotive powered by diesel. This statement is wrong. So answer is A, that is one only. Statement 2 is incorrect because the RORO, that is roll on and roll off initiative by Indian Railways, involves carrying loaded road going trucks on flat wagons to decongest roads in the National Capital Region. And RORO service aims to reduce carbon emission and congestion on the roads of the NCR, as about 66,000 diesel guzzling trucks pass through Delhi and its adjoining areas in a day. Question number 3. Consider the following statements on Nari Shakti Puraskars, that is Women Power Awards. Okay, so it is the national award for women presented by Ministry of Women and Child Development. This is correct. It is awarded to both institutions and individuals who have rendered distinguished services to the cause of women. This is also correct. It is awarded on the eve of Republic Day every year. This is wrong. Answer is 1 and 2. So statement 3 is incorrect. Nari Shakti Puraskars awarded on the eve of International Women's Day, that is March 8th. And the campaign theme for United Nations International Women's Day 2017 is Be Bold for Change. Question number 4. With regard to olive ridley turtles, consider the following statements. They have circumtropical distribution, living in the tropical and warm waters of Pacific and Indian Oceans. Okay, this is absolutely correct. They are known for their synchronized mass nesting, termed as aribadas. This is also correct. In the Indian Ocean region, the majority of the olive ridley nesting sites are over the coast of Odisha and Coromandel coast. This is also correct. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3. So, olive ridley turtles are primarily found in the tropical and warm waters of Pacific, Southern Atlantic and Indian Oceans, from India, Arabia, Micronesia to South Africa, Australia and New Zealand. And their nesting patches are called as aribadas. Question number 5. Which of the following pairs are correctly matched? Tejas light combat aircraft from DRDO, Swati weapon locate radar ADAHAL, Kalahari Scorpion submarine, Mazagon Docks Limited MDL. This is correct. Third is 100% correctly matched. Dhruv multi-role utility helicopter Hall. This is also correct. So third and fourth are correctly matched, because Tejas is built by Hall and Swati is built by DRDO. So these are like wrongly matched. Answer is 3 and 4 C. So Tejas, that is light combat aircraft, it is built by ADA Hall. And Swati weapon locating radar, it is an indigenously developed system by DRDO. Question number 6. With regards to the scheme for development of solar parks and ultra mega solar power projects, consider the following statements. They are financed through International Solar Alliance, to which India is a founding member. And the scheme will set up solar parks and ultra mega solar power projects of 40,000 megawatt total capacity by 2019-20. Select the correct answer below. Answer is B, that is 2 only here. Okay, so first is wrong. So Ministry of New and Renewable Energy is implementing this scheme with the financial support of ₹8,100 crore from the Union Government, and with an enhanced capacity up to 40,000 megawatt of power generation, the solar parks will generate 64 billion units of electricity per year and resulting in abatement of around 55 million tons of carbon dioxide every year. Question number 7. Consider the following statements on the Indus River. Kishan Ganga River, a tributary of Jhelum River, is known as Neelam River in Pakistan. Okay, this is correct. Rattle hydroelectric plant is being constructed on the River Satluj. This is wrong. Arun 3 hydroelectric project is to be constructed on Arun River, a tributary of Chenab. This is also wrong. Answer is A, that is 1 only. So statement 2 is incorrect, because Rattle hydroelectric plant is a run of the river power station currently under construction on the Chenab River in Rattle village of Doda district, Jammu and Kashmir. And statement 3 is also incorrect, as the Arun River is in eastern Nepal. Question number 8. Select the correct statement on the writ jurisdiction of high courts. The writ jurisdiction of High Court is not exclusive, but is wider than that of Supreme Court. The writ jurisdiction of High Court is a part of basic structure of Constitution. Tribunals cannot be subjected to the writ jurisdiction of High Court. So answer is B. So statement 3 is incorrect. In 1997, Supreme Court has ruled that even tribunals are subjected to the writ jurisdiction of High Courts. And in fact, an aggrieved person cannot move to Supreme Court directly against the decisions of a tribunal without appealing in the High Courts first. Question number 9. With regard to Indian monsoon, consider the following statements. It involves northwest monsoon winds and southeast monsoon winds. It involves seasonal reversal of winds, and it is characterized by rainfall in summer and dry winters. Statement 2 and 3 are correct, because it is southwest monsoon winds and northeast monsoon winds. So first is wrong. So you have to read them carefully. Statement 2 is correct. 3 is correct. Answer is C, 2 and 3 only. Last question for the day is, select the correct statements on the independence of the Supreme Court of India. So a judgment of Supreme Court can be removed by an order of precedent passed after an address by each House of Parliament on grounds of proved misbehavior or incapacity. The salaries of judges are charged on contingency fund of India and not put to vote in Parliament. The Chief Justice of India can appoint officers and servants of Supreme Court without any interference from the executive. Then the conduct of judges of Supreme Court cannot be discussed in Parliament or in state legislature. Second statement is wrong. 1, 3, 4 is the correct answer. So all the expenses of the Supreme Court, including the salaries, allowances and pensions of its judges, are charged on the Consolidated Fund of India, and they are non-votable by Parliament, although it can discuss. So I hope you have learned a lot from this lesson. Thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day.
Guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs based on the 5th March 2017 current affairs. So let's get started. Instructions are pretty clear. Question number 1. Consider the following statements on Jal Kranti Abhiyan. The initiatives is jointly run by the three ministries of Agriculture, Rural Development and Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. Under the program, two water-stressed villages in each district are affected with a compromised water security plan, comprehensive water security plan. It offers protective irrigations for all the farms. Answer is B, that is 2 only. So, statement 1 and 3 are incorrect as they are the features of Prime Minister Krishi Sichai Yojana, PMKSY. And Jal Kranti Abhiyan, JK, is a brainchild of Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. And it was launched in year 2015. And so far, 726 villages have been identified under JKA with an integrated water security plan prepared for 180, of which 61 of them are already approved. Question number 2, which of the following statements regarding IPO is or are correct? IPO is, it is the first sale of shares to public investors by a privately owned company, yes. It enlarges equity base and enables cheaper access to capital for the firm, yes. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So both these statements are correct, and those companies that has never issued equity to the public in the past, and when they issue for the first time, it is known as the IPO of the company. Question number 3, consider the following statements about National Family Health Survey, NFHS. It is conducted by NSSO. NFHS is conducted by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare with the International Institute for Population Science. So first statement is wrong. It provides essential data on health and family welfare needed for policy and programming purposes. This is correct. Answer is B, 2 only. So statement 1 is incorrect. All NFHS are conducted under the leadership of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare with the International Institute for Population Science, Mumbai, serving as the nodal agency. And NFHS is a large scale multi-round survey conducted in a representative sample of household throughout India, and the fourth round of NFHS were carried out in 2014-15. Question number 4, with regards to National Human Rights Commission of India, consider the following statements. It is not a constitutional body. Okay, yes, it is correct. It has all the powers of a civil court and its proceedings have judicial character, yes. The Protection of Human Rights Act of 1993 provides for establishment of State Human Rights Commission and Human Rights Court in every district. This is also correct. Answer is D. All the statements are correct. Moreover, NHRC can look into a matter only within an year of its occurrence. You can't do it 30 years down the line. And its recommendations are not binding on the concerned government or authority, but it should be informed about the action taken on its recommendation within 1 month. Question number 5. Which of the following pairs are correctly matched? So, Subhash Chandra Bose, Forward Block, 100% correct. Shri Narayan Guru, Justice Party. Justice Party was made in Madras Presidency by T.M. Nair, Thyagacharya Chetty and Natesha Mudaliar. So, this is wrong. Dr. Ambedkar, Scheduled Caste Federation, yes. M.N. Roy, Purv Sarvajanik Sabha, no. M.G. Ranade formed Purv Pune Sarvajanik Sabha. And M.N. Roy made the Communist Party of India. He was associated with that. Mahadev Govind Ranade made the Pune Sarvajanik Sabha in 1870. Answer is B, that is 1 and 3 only. So here you can read more about it. Question number 6, with regards to the 3-stage nuclear program of India, consider the following statements. In the first stage, pressurized heavy water reactor is used with natural thorium as fuel. India has high thorium reserves, unlike scarce uranium reserves. Select the correct statement. So answer is B, only 2 is correct. Statement 1 is incorrect as the fuel for the pressurized heavy water reactors PHWR in stage 1 is natural uranium. And statement 2 is correct. With high thorium reserves, India plans to use natural thorium in the stage 3 after generating sufficient fissile material from the uranium fueled PHWR in stage 1 and plutonium fueled fast breeder reactor from stage 2. Question number 7. Consider the following statements on Humboldt Peru ocean current. It is a warm current. It is wrong. It is a cold current. So first statement is wrong. Only A or C can be the correct answer. In general, El Nino disrupts the Humboldt's current system. Yes, this is correct. Since 2 is there already on the option, you don't even need to read it. So answer is 2 and 3, that is C. So statement 1 is incorrect as the Humboldt current is a cold current that flows north along the west coast of South America from the southern tip of Chile to northern Peru. And El Nino involves warmer conditions than average over the surface waters near the west coast of South America. So it also negatively impacts the summer monsoon in South Asia, so please note that. Question number 8, the weekly iron folic acid supplementation program run by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare aims to reduce the prevalence and severity of which of the following? Here the answer is anemia, obviously. So the weekly iron and folic acid supplementation program tries to reduce the high prevalence and incidence of anemia amongst adolescents, girls, pregnant women, boys in the age of 10 to 19 years age group. and it involves administration of supervised weekly iron folic acid supplements of 100 milligram elemental iron and 500 microgram of folic acid using a fixed day approach. So question number 9, Aksai chain is one of the hotbed of India-China border disputes. In this regard, consider the following statements. It is situated in Arunachal Pradesh, absolutely wrong. It is situated in Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh region. This is absolutely wrong. The region is mostly a high altitude desert and with little precipitation due to orographic barriers preventing rains from Indian monsoon. Sorry for this, there is no third statement here. Answer is 2 only, B. So statement 1 is incorrect, as Aksai chain is the Ladakh region of state of Jammu and Kashmir. And statement 1 is actually corroborates with Tawang, which is situated in Arunachal Pradesh, bordered by Tibet in the north and Bhutan in the north southwest. Last question for the day is, which of the following statements on ecologically sensitive area is or are correct? They are demarcated by National Green Tribunal after proposal sent by respective state governments and union territories. Commercial activities like mining and constructions of thermal power plants are prohibited in the ESA. Which of the following statement is correct? So answer here is B, that is 2 only. First statement is wrong. So statement 1 is incorrect. The guidelines for ESAs were issued by Ministry of Environment and Forest, and states and UTs are asked to constitute a committee comprising wildlife warden, an ecologist and a revenue of department official to suggest the requirement of an eco-sensitive zone and its extent. And the primary objective of ESA is to prevent ecological damage caused due to developmental activities around national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. So I hope you learned a lot from this. Thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day.
Hey guys, what's up? So today we will discuss the MCQs based on 6 March 2017 current affairs, and they are presented by me, Roman Seni. So let's get started. So instructions are pretty clear, so please follow them. Question number 1, consider the following statements on preamble of Indian Constitution. It is part of the basic structure of the Constitution, yes. It does not confer any powers to legislature nor prohibit upon powers of legislature, yes. It is non-justiciable in nature, yes. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so all of them are correct. So all these statements are correct regarding preamble. You should know one or like every odd year they ask a question from it. Question number 2. Which of the following statements regarding unique identification authority of India is or are correct? It is statutory authority. Yes, this is 100% correct. It issues Aadhaar unique identity, which is not a proof of citizenship, but a right on its own to domicile in India. So second statement is wrong. Statement A is correct because now it is a statutory organization. So UIDAI is now a statutory organization under Aadhaar, that is Targeted Delivery of Financial and Other Subsidies, Benefits and Transfer Services Act of 2016. And Aadhaar identity neither confers a valid proof of citizenship nor grant any rights to domicile in India. So it is like neither or this. Both of them are not under Aadhaar. Question number 3. Consider the following statements on GST Council. It is created under the provisions of Article 279A of the Constitution. Yes, this is correct. 2. It comprises of Union Finance Minister, Finance Ministers of each states, and industry experts nominated by the Union Government. No, this is absolutely wrong. The GST Council consists of the following. Union Minister as Chairperson, Union Minister of State in charge of Revenue of Finance as Member, and Minister in charge of Finance or Taxation or any other Minister nominated by each state government as Member. So statement 2 is incorrect. Only the first statement is correct. Answer is A, 1 only. Question number 4, with regard Shahpur-Kandi Dam project that was recently on news, consider the following statements. It is being constructed across the river Ravi in the state of Punjab. It was halted in 2014 due to disputes between India and Pakistan over water sharing under Indus Water Treaty. Which of the following statement is correct? Statement 1 is correct, 100%. Statement 2 is wrong. Because the Shahpur-Kandi Dam project was caught into disputes between the states of Punjab and J&K. That is why statement 2 is incorrect. And on March 3, 2017, an agreement was reached between the parties, thereby resolving the issues and resuming the constructions. And Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation, it provides central assistance of 90% of the balance cost of works, component of irrigation and water supply. Question number 5, which of the following are pairs are correctly matched? So here the answer is Loktak Lake is in Manipur, yes, 100% correct. Koleru Lake is in Andhra Pradesh, so this is wrong. Ashtamudi Lake is in Kerala, so this is also wrong. And Harike Wetland is in Punjab, this is also wrong. So answer is A, that is 1 only. So Koleru Lake is in Andhra Pradesh, Ashtamudi Lake is in Kerala, while Harike Wetland is in Punjab at the confluence of Bias and Satluj rivers. And all the 4 are included in the Ramsar sites on wetlands. So that is why it is important to remember them. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 विद रिगार्ड टू उज्ज्वल डिस्कॉम अश्योरेंस योजना उदय कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इट ऑफर्स फाइनेंशियल टर्न अराउंड एंड रिवाइवल ऑफ स्टेट रन पावर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनीज बाय अ ट्राइपार्टाइट एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट कंसर्न स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड द कंपनी एंड द स्कीम इज ऑप्शनल फॉर द स्टेट्स येस बोथ दी स्टेटमेंट्स आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट सो आंसर इज सी दैट इज बोथ 1 and 2 सो उदय स्कीम्स अलाउज स्टेट गवर्नमेंट टू टेक ओवर 75% ऑफ द डेट एंड पे बैक लेंडर्स बाय सेलिंग बॉन्ड्स and distribution companies are expected to issue bonds for the remaining 25% of their debt. Question number 7. Consider the following statements on acidification of ocean waters. It is a result of uptake of atmospheric carbon dioxide by oceans. So this is correct. It results in higher concentration of hydrogen ions and reduced concentration of carbonate ions. And the pH level of ocean water is reduced. So obviously pH level is reduced. It means acidification happens. It happens by CO2. It leads to higher concentration of hydrogen ions. All the three are absolutely correct. Basic chemistry. Answer is D 1, 2, 3. Acidified water becomes less alkaline. That is lower pH level. Question number 8. The Sanskritic phase of Vasudev Kutumbakam engraved in the entrance hall of the Parliament of India is adopted from which of the following? So Vasudev Kutumbakam was there in Mahaupanishad. So everybody should know that word Vasudev Kutumbakam. Kutumbakam means family, Vasudev means the entire universe or world or whatever you want to call it. So Vasudev Kutumbakam, which literally means the world is a single family, is sourced from chapter 6 of Mahaupanishad, which is a Vaishnavite text. So that is also important. Question number 9, which of the following tiger reserves are situated in and around Western Ghats? So here, Kallakad Mundanthurai is yes, Nagarhol, yes, Biligiri Ranga, yes. Achanakmar definitely not. Simlipal is in Odisha, nothing to do with here. Achanakmar is in Chhattisgarh, so this is also wrong. Answer is 1, 2, 3, B. So Achanakmar Tiger Reserve is in the state of Chhattisgarh. It is also a part of Achanakmar Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve. Simlipal Tiger Reserve is in the state of Odisha. Kalakad Mundanthurai is in Tamil Nadu, while Nagarhol and Biligiri Ranga are in Karnataka. All of them are situated in the Western Ghats. So that is also very, very clear. And last question for the day is, which of the following statements on hydrochlorofluorocarbons, that is HCFCs, is or are correct? So HCFCs are used for refrigeration and air conditioning as an alternative to ozone depleting chlorofluorocarbons, and due to their high global warming potentials, HCFCs are replaced with a variety of hydrocarbon based substitutes. So which of the following statement is correct? So here both 1 and 2 statements are absolutely correct. So here the answer is C. So, United Nations Environment Programme reports that the increase in HFC emission is projected to offset much of the climate benefit which were achieved by the earlier reduction in the emission of ozone-depleting substances. So, we are back to square one. Dhak ke teen paas, jahan se chale wahin lot ke aage. And hydrocarbons have zero ozone depletion potential and also low global warming potential. So, I hope you learned a lot from this lesson. Thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day.
Hey guys, what's up? So please enroll in this course if you have not done already. And if you like this course, please rate, review and recommend as much as possible. These are the MCQs based on the 7th March 2017 current affairs for UPSC CSE prelims 2017. Instructions are pretty clear, so please follow them. Question number 1, consider the following statements on multi-purpose projects on the streams of Ganges River in Uttarakhand or Ganga River. Koteshwar Dam is built across the Alaknanda River. This is wrong because Koteshwar and Tehri Dam projects are constructed across Bhagirathi River. Second statement is correct since first is wrong. So the only option and second is correct. So the only option is C, that is 2 and 3. So even if you do not know the third option, you can still make it right. And both Alaknanda and Bhagirathi streams meet at Devprayag to form Ganga River. So this is correct. Answer is C, 2 and 3. So statement 1 is incorrect because both Koteshwar and Tehri Dam projects are constructed across the Bhagirathi River. Question number 2. Which of the following statements regarding the proposed national food grid is or are correct? Analogous to electricity grid, national food grid would connect deficient areas of food production with producing regions. Very important, it is required, yes. National food grid can ensure stable food prices and lower food inflation. Which of the following is correct? Yes, dono makes logical sense. Both of them are correct, both 1 and 2. So, a comprehensive national food processing policy is on the making, which is likely to focus on building India's national food grid and national cold chain grid. So, answer is C. Question number 3, consider the following statements on INS Virat. It was bought from Russia. It was India's first aircraft carrier. Absolutely, both the statements are wrong. It was bought from UK and INS Vikrant was India's first aircraft carrier. Since it is in news because it has been decommissioned recently, answer is D, none of the above.
So INS Virat, that was just decommissioned yesterday, was bought from United Kingdom. It served as HMS Hermes in the Royal Navy before it was sold to India in 1987. And INS Vikrant was India's first aircraft carrier, and a new aircraft carrier on the same name is being indigenously built in India for the first time by Cochin Shipyard Limited in Kochi for the Indian Navy. Question number 4, with regards to Hyperloop technology that was recently in news, consider the following statements. It is a high-speed mobility solution that involves sending magnetically levitated pods through low-pressure tubes at very high speeds. 100% correct. Elon Musk was also talking about this. One such system is currently under development between Abu Dhabi and Dubai. Yes, both of them are correct. Answer is 1 and 2. So Hyperloop technology was proposed by inventor and e-mobility businessman Elon Musk of Tesla Motors and SpaceX commercial agency. And Hyperloop One is the company behind the project, which has recently opened a vote on 5 potential routes in India. Question number 5. Which of the following pairs on schisms in 4th Buddhist councils are correctly matched? So, first council, Vajikas versus non-Vajikas. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Second council, Mahasangikas versus Sarvastivadins. This is wrong because they were divided into Theravadins, this Tharvadins and Mahasangikas. So this is not correctly matched. And third council, Mahasangikas versus Theravadins. So this is also wrong. At the third councils, so they were divided into tell you the now. And fourth council, Mahayan versus Hinayan. So this is correct. Answer is B, 1 and 4 are correctly matched, because at the third council, which was held at Pataliputra around 250 BC, Sarvastivadins sect, popular in Kashmir and Madhura regions, were the principal rival camps for the Mahasangikas, and in the fourth council they united together to form Mahayan or the greater vehicle tradition of Buddhism. Question number 6. With regard to freedom of press in India, consider the following statements. There is no specific provision in the constitution guaranteeing the freedom of press apart from Article 19(1)(a). And freedom of press is also subject to reasonable restriction that apply to freedom of speech and expression. Yes, obviously it is subject to reasonable restriction, and yes, there is no specific provisions apart from this article. So answer is C, both 1 and 2. So both these statements are absolutely correct here. Question number 7. Consider the following statements on Pragati. Pragati ki full form hai proactive governance and timely implementation. It is a multi-purpose interactive platform that seeks to bring e-transparency and e-accountability. This is 100% correct. It can monitor and review projects of both central and state government. So this is also 100% correct. It seeks to promote cooperative federalism through its interactive three-tier system. Which of the following statement is correct? So all these statements are absolutely correct here. So Pragati platform uniquely bundles three key technologies. One is digital data management, video conferencing and geospatial technology, and it also promotes cooperative federalism by bringing secretaries of government of India and the chief secretaries of the states together on a common governance platform. Question number 8, consider the following statements on National Investment and Infrastructure Fund, NIIF. It provides equity or quasi-equity support to non-banking financial companies and other financial institutions engaged in infrastructure financing. It raises funds through various instruments like offshore credit enhanced bonds and attracting anchor investors to participate as partners in NIIF. Which of the following statement is correct? So here both these statements are correct, both 1 and 2 are correct. So National Investment and Infrastructure Fund, NIIF, that became operational last year. It is a fund which was created by Government of India for enhancing infrastructure financing in the country. And it has just begun talks with two sovereign wealth funds to become the first investor on board. So that is why both these statements are correct. Answer is C. The Tropic of Cancer passes through which of the following states in India? So I have made a lesson where I have made a mnemonic regarding that. So you can enroll in my course, Most Important Topics for UPSC CSC, and you can watch the lessons there. So here the answer is Manipur is not. So the Gujarat. So it definitely passes through Madhya Pradesh, it definitely passes through Gujarat, okay, and it does not pass through Manipur. So 3 cannot be the answer. And so sorry for this mistake. It should be yes, it definitely passes through Mizoram, it should pass through Jharkhand, it passes through Tripura. So it should be 12456, it should not be 13456. Sorry for this mistake. And answer is 12456. So you can see it passes through Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Tripura and Mizoram. Please remember these 8 states out of 29. These are the states through which Tropic of Cancer passes, and it is a very common question in lot of government exams. And finally, Which of the following statements on denitrification is or are correct? It is a microbial process that occurs in soil when oxygen is depleted. It is a desirable process in sewage treatment system. Select the correct codes. So here both these statements are correct, that is both 1 and 2 are correct. So denitrification, it takes place in anoxic environments where oxygen consumption, that is the where the entire oxygen that is being consumed, it is more than the oxygen supplied, and where sufficient quantities of nitrates are present, and it is commonly used to remove nitrogen from sewage and municipal wastewater. But production of nitrous oxide in the process, which is an ozone depleting substance and a greenhouse gas, can have a considerable influence on global warming. So I hope you have learned a lot from this lesson. Do recommend, rate and review. Thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day. Guys, what's up? So please enroll in this course so that you get notifications whenever I make a lesson. And these are the expected MCQs based on the current affairs of 8th March 2017, presented by me, Roman Saini. Instructions are pretty clear, so you can follow it here. Question number 1. Consider the following statements on angel investors. They invest in startups and small businesses with relatively more favorable terms and returns than other lenders. They use crowdfunding platforms to pool capital. Okay, this is definitely wrong. Most often they invest on those businesses which are owned by their family members or friends. Which of the following statement is correct? Answer is A, 1 and 3 only. Second is wrong. So statement 2 is incorrect. Angel investors often use their own money or resources to pool capital for investing, while venture capitalists, that is VCs, on the other hand, use crowdfunding platforms and networks of investors to source capital and then they invest at one go. Question number 2. Consider the following statements on Central Statistical Organization. It prepares quarterly estimates of GDP at current and constant prices and compiles all India index of industrial production. Okay, this is correct. It works under the aegis of Ministry of Finance. No, it works under Ministry of MOSPI, Statistics and Program Implementation. Second is wrong, first is correct. So statement 2 is incorrect. CSO works under the aegis of Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. And National Accounts Division of CSO prepares quarterly estimates of GDP at current and constant prices. And Economic Statistics Division of CSO compiles all India index of industrial production. Question number 3. Liquefied natural gas by nature is almost odorless. To make it odor detectable to identify leakage, which of the following substances is added? The answer is ethyl mercaptan. So please remember this. And ethanol and methanol are nothing but alcohol. Ethyl mercaptan is used as an odorant in LPG to make it detectable. So whenever you leave your gas by mistake on, so you have a very pungent smell, that is because of ethyl mercaptan. Question number 4. Consider the following statements on income method of GDP calculation. It provides a lower value of GDP than expenditure method for the same year. This is wrong. Okay, so whether it is expenditure or value added or income, it is equal. The calculation will always be equal. It considers incomes received by factors of production only. This is correct. Answer is 2 only. So statement 1 is incorrect. As the value of GDP calculated by all the three methods, that is expenditure, value added and income, is equal for the given year. And GDP by income method is calculated by adding the incomes received by factors of production, such as wages by labor, rent by land, profit by entrepreneur, interest by capital. Please remember these 4 points. GDP Act factor cost plus production taxes minus production subsidies is GVA at basic price. GVA at basic prices plus product tax minus product subsidies is GDP at current price, current market price, and GDP adjusted for inflation is GDP at constant market price. So please remember that. So let's move forward. Question number 5. Consider the following statements on National Green Tribunal. So it is a statutory agency established under Environment Protection Act of 1986. No, it has a separate act. It is called as NGT Act of 2010. First statement is 100% wrong. Answer cannot be A, it cannot be B, it cannot be D. The only possible answer which can be true is C, that is 2 and 3. So they have to be true. So tribunal is guided by the principle of natural justice. Obviously everything is guided by principles of natural justice. And high courts have jurisdiction to entertain appeals against the orders of NGT. Yes, they have. Answer is C, 2 and 3. So statement 1 is incorrect. NGT is established under National Green Tribunal Act of 2010 for expeditious disposal of cases related to environmental protection, conservation of forest and natural resources. And the tribunal is not guided by the procedure laid down under the Code of Civil Procedure 1908, while it is guided by the principles of natural justice. And as per NGT Act, appeals against NGT orders can be heard only at the Supreme Court. But Madras High Court has disagreed on this. It has stressed that the bar imposed on lower courts by the Act, excluding them from deliberating environmental cases, does not extend to the High Courts, as its jurisdiction under Article 226 and 227 are part of the basic structure of the Constitution, and no act or no constitutional amendment act or anything can take away the basic structure of the Constitution. Question number 6, with regard to vitamin D, consider the following statements. It is produced by the body in response to skin being exposed to sunlight. Everybody knows it. Its deficiency causes rickets, leading to soft bones and skeletal deformities. Both the statements are absolutely correct. Answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So it causes rickets in children. Osteomalacia happens in adults. Okay, so both the statements are correct. And vitamin D also occurs naturally in food items like fish, egg yolks, and in fortified dairy and grain products. And symptoms of bone pain and muscle weakness can mean that you have a vitamin D deficiency. So you should know rickets and osteomalacia are caused by it. Scurvy is caused by vitamin C deficiency. Question number 7. Consider the following statements on mango showers. These are summer season pre-monsoon showers that help in early ripening of mangoes. Hence, they are called as mango showers. Yes, these type of showers are more prevalent in temperate regions. Okay, they are 100% wrong. They are more prevalent in tropical climate, especially South Asia, Southeast Asia, like Kerala. So answer second is wrong, first is correct. Answer is A. Statement 2 is incorrect. Pre-monsoon showers are more prevalent in tropics, especially South and Southeast Asia. They occur in the month of March and April. They are common in Kerala, Karnataka, and parts of Tamil Nadu in India. Question number 8. Consider the following statements on ISGAN, that is International Smart Grid Action Network. It is a platform that seeks multilateral collaboration to advance the development and deployment of smarter electric grid technologies, practices and systems, and it is an agreement under International Solar Alliance. Select the correct statement. Second is wrong because it is an agreement under International Energy Agency and India is represented by Ministry of Power. It is one of the founding members. So statement 2 is wrong. Answer is A, only 1. Statement 2 is incorrect. ISGAN is an agreement under International Energy Agency with 25 members on board. India is represented by Ministry of Power. It is one of the founding members. Question number 9. Which of the following are the west flowing rivers in India? West flowing rivers in India are Narmada, definitely. Sabarmati, yes. Then you have Periyar, Mandovi. But Vaigai is situated in the southern part of Tamil Nadu and it flows from west to east. So Vaigai is not there. Answer is 1, 2, 4, 5. So Vaigai is east flowing while these are west flowing. Very few rivers in India flow westwards. Many rivers flow eastwards. So river Vaigai is situated in the southern part of state of Tamil Nadu and flows from west to east, just like most of the rivers. Question number 10. Which of the following statements on trademarks in India is or are correct? It is administered by the Controller General of Patents, Designs, Trade and Marks. 100% correct. It is a signatory to Madrid Protocol, a treaty under the Madrid system for international registration of trademarks. Which of the following statement is correct? Answer is C, both 1 and 2 are correct. So Government of India has notified the Trademarks Rules of 2017, which replaced the erstwhile Trademarks Rule of 2010 to streamline and simplify the process of trademark applications. And Trademarks Registry acts as a resource and information center, and it is a facilitator in matters relating to trademarks in India. So I hope you have learned a lot from this lesson. Thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day. Hey guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs based on the 9th March 2017 current affairs. And this is presented by me, Roman Saini. Instructions are pretty clear, so you can watch them here. Question number 1. Which of the following countries border with North Korea, also known as Democratic People's Republic of Korea? South Korea, obviously there because they used to be one country at one time. China has a huge border and Russia has a very small border with it. So answer is South Korea, China and Russia. Answer is 1, 2, 4, that is D. So North Korea, as you can see, this is this one border, this is another border and this is with South Korea. This entire is China. So North Korea borders with China, Russia over the north and South Korea over the southern side. This is Japan. Question number 2. Which of the following statements on National Commission for Protection of Child Rights is or are correct? It is a statutory body. Obviously, it is a statutory body because it is under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act of 2005 and under the administrative control of Ministry of Women and Child Development. And it is in consonance with United Nations Conventions on the Rights of the Child, UNCRC, to which India is a signatory. So which of the following is correct? Answer is C, both 1 and 2 are absolutely correct in this regard. So NCPCR is a statutory body under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act of 2005. And United Nations Conventions on the Rights of the Child, UNCRC of 1989, sets out civil, political, economic, social, health and cultural rights of children. Question number 3. Pobitora Wildlife Sanctuary, which was on the news recently, is located in which of the following states? So it is located in the Morigaon district of the state of Assam. So Bobby-Thora Wildlife Sanctuary, it is located in Morigaon district of the state of Assam, and it is mainly famous for its great Indian one-horned rhinoceros. Like, it is a beautiful creature of nature, and it is also home to more than 2,000 migratory birds and various reptiles, and it is an important bird area under BirdLife International. Study of birds is called as ornithology. Ornithology. Question number 4. Consider the following statements on Common Service Centers program, CSCs. They enable people in rural areas to access government services online. They are run by India Post at the first level, village level of the scheme. Which of the following statement is correct? So here only the first statement is correct. Second is wrong because they are run by village level entrepreneurs. So CSCs are run by village level entrepreneurs at the first level villages according to the scheme. And CSCs are the access point for delivery of various electronic services to villages in India, and thereby they contribute to a digitally and financially inclusive society. And it is an initiative of Department of Electronics and IT, that is DT, under Ministry of Communications and IT. And CSC 2.0 scheme is an integral part of Digital India program under the NDA government. So answer is A. Question number 5. Arrange the following water bodies between India and Sri Lanka in north to south direction. So if we go from north to south, first you'll have Park Strait, then you'll have Park Bay, then you have the Gulf of Mannar, and then you'll have Indian Ocean. But technically, like, everything is Indian Ocean, but still, like, if you include these four, so here the answer is B, that is 2, 3, 4, 1. So this is Park Strait. So if you can see, this is called as the Jaffna Peninsula, and it is between India, and this is the Park Bay. Okay, so there is a, what do you mean by strait? Can you write the definition in comments below? I'll really appreciate it. This is Gulf of Mannar. This is also one of the biosphere reserves. And finally, you have Indian Ocean. So you can see this is Tamil Nadu. This is Kerala. This is the Jaffna Peninsula. This region of Sri Lanka, northern Sri Lanka. Question number 6. With regards to IORA, that is Indian Ocean Rim Association, consider the following statements. It has 21 member countries bordering the Indian Ocean. The apex body of IORA is a Council of Foreign Ministers, COM. Select the correct answers using the codes below. So here both the statements are absolutely correct. So answer is C. So IORA is a regional forum bringing together representatives of governments of Indian Ocean bordering nations, business and academia for promoting cooperation and sustainable growth and balanced developments of the region. And it consists of 21 member states and 7 dialogue partners. So here answer is C. Question number 7. Consider the following statements on Roper Wetland in the state of Punjab. It is a freshwater riverine wetland system with a human-made barrage, and it is only Ramsar Convention site for conservation of wetlands in the state of Punjab. Select the correct codes. So here only the first statement is correct because Punjab has 3 Ramsar Convention. One is Harika Dam, Khanjil, Roper. Harika you must have heard. Harika, Khanjil and Roper. So the first, second statement is definitely correct. First is right. So answer is A, that is one only. So statement 2 is incorrect because Punjab has 3 Ramsar Convention sites for conservation of wetlands. Harika, that is Bias and Satluj rivers, Khanjil on Kali river and Roper on Satluj river. Question number 8. Consider the following statements on global warming potential, GWP, okay, not GDP. It is a relative measure of total energy a gas absorbs usually over 100 years compared to carbon dioxide. 100% correct. The GWP of carbon dioxide is valued at 1, so that is why it is a relative, right? So answer is C, both 1 and 2. Both these statements are correct. The amount of heat trapped by a unit, 1 ton of carbon dioxide, is the baseline for reckoning the GWP values for other gases. And carbon dioxide by definition has a GWP of 1 regardless of the time period used, because it is the gas being used as a reference. Question number 9. Which of the following are correctly matched here? So Jaydev, Geet Govind, Chand Bardai, Prithvi Raj, Kalhan, Raj Tarangini, Ilango Vedigal, Shilapati Gram. So all the four are absolutely correctly matched. They are the classics of ancient and medieval India. So please, please remember them. So like, they are usually asked very frequently, and especially if you find, go to art and culture section of paper 1 and in prelims. So they might ask you Sangam literature books, so you can mention this Shilapati Gram. So answer is 1, 2, 3, 4. All the are correctly matched. And last question for the day is, which of the following statements on... So with respect to edge effect, which of the following statements are correct? It is regarded as a sign of ecological degradation by ecologists. Obviously, this is absolutely correct. And fragmentation of habitats of flora and fauna results in increase of edge areas. So both the statements are correct in this case. It's a classical question which is asked in environment and ecology section. Edge effect, ecotone, ecard, ecofine. So a lot of words which starts with E. So it becomes difficult to differentiate between them. So I will request you to revise them a lot often. So both these statements are correct. So edge effect refers to the changes in population or the community structures that occur at the boundary of two habitats. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day.
Hey guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs based on the 10th March 2017 current affairs. And this is presented by me, Roman Saini. So let's get started. Instructions are same. Please enroll in this course. Question number one, which of the following tiger reserves are located in the Strait of Uttarakhand? Obviously, Corbett is located here. Okay, and Rajaji is also located here. And so here the answer will be 2 and 3 because Kaziranga and Panna are not located in the state of Uttarakhand. So Corbett and Rajaji tiger reserves are located in the state of Uttarakhand. And the state is likely to get two more tiger reserves in the name of Nandhor and Surai Range. Question number 2, which of the following statements on Pradhan Mantri Ujjwal Yojana is or are correct? The scheme provides for LPG connections free of cost to women members of households below poverty line, and Aadhaar card is mandatory for availing benefits under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwal Yojana. So here both these statements are correct. So the scheme empowers women and protects their health as they face serious health concerns out of smoke during the process of cooking using the fuel wood. Question number 3, the National Pension Scheme is administered and regulated by which of the following organization? So it is done by Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority, that is PFRDA. Okay, so just remember that since it talks about pension and it is also talking about pension, so that is the logical thing to remember. So NPS is a voluntary contribution scheme that offers a variety of investment options to employees, and it is not only available to government servants but it is available to private sector as well. Its main objective is to lower the liabilities of Government of India with regard to total pension and to ensure a stable income for employees post retirement along with decent returns for their investments also. Question number 4, consider the following statements on trade facilitation agreement under WTO. A 2/3 of WTO members have already ratified the TFA, and TFA aims to streamline international customs practices and ease the trade movements across geographical and political borders. Select the correct statement here. Both these statements are absolutely correct. So answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So the TFA came into force last month with 112 nations ratifying the agreement and accounting for more than 2/3 of all the members in WTO. So that was your TFA. So then you have question number 5. Consider the following statements on border hearts. So they promote the livelihood of people living in remote areas across the borders of two countries by establishing traditional system of marketing the local produce through local markets, and such traditional marketing is carried out in barter system only. Obviously you can have like currencies, or why do you need barter system for that? We are not living 2000 years ago. So second statement is wrong. First statement is correct. Answer is A, one only. So usually border hearts are permitted to be carried out either in Indian rupees or currency of the neighboring nation, and also on the border barter basis as well. And the data of such trade is maintained by the Heart Management Committee of the respective border heart. So answer is A. Question number 6, which of the following pairs are correctly matched? So let us select the correct codes below. So Vadhavan is in Maharashtra. Yes, Sarkazi is located in Tamil Nadu. So that is why it is wrong. And these are the 6 proposed port locations identified under the Sagarmala program. Sarkazi is in Tamil Nadu. First is wrong. Second is correct. Sagar Island is in West Bengal. Paradeep is in definitely in Odisha. So answer is D, that is 2, 3, 4. So as I already said, Sarkazi is located in Tamil Nadu, and these are the 6 proposed port locations identified under the Sagarmala program. So it will help in increasing the share of coastal shipping and inland navigation in the transport model mix. It is one of the key objectives of the Sagarmala program. So you should know about such initiatives taken by the Government of India. They are very helpful for your prelims and mains. Question number 7. Consider the following statements about National Highways Authority of India Act. It is a special purpose entry established by an executive order by Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. So this is wrong because it is a statutory institution by the Act of Parliament, National Highways Authority of India Act of 1988.
So this is wrong, and it is responsible for the development, maintenance and management of national highways in India. Obviously this is correct. Answer is B, that is 2 only. The statement 1 is wrong. So as you can see, statement 1 is incorrect, because NHAI is a statutory institution which is constituted by an act of parliament, the National Highways Authority of India Act of 1988. Question number 8, consider the following statements on biogas. So biogas is obtained from anaerobic degradation of organic wastes. So that is statement is correct, 1 is correct. And National Biogas and Manure Management Program is part of NAPCC. Okay, this is definitely not part of NAPCC. This is 100% wrong, because I know all the 8 which are under the NAPCC. So here it is a central sector scheme, so that is why it is wrong. Statement A is correct, so answer is 1 only. So as I was saying, statement 2 is incorrect, as National Biogas and Manure Management Program is a central sector scheme, and it provides for setting up of family type biogas plants which can be used at individual level also, or for small communities, mainly for rural and semi-urban households. Question number 9, second last question of the day, is which of the following are matched correctly? So these are the projects, basically Mulla Periyar is on our Periyar River. So obviously Periyar is correct. Kishanganga is on Jhelum River. No, Kishanganga is, this statement is wrong here. And Baglihar is in Chenab River, so that is correct. And Polavaram is on Krishna River, so that is wrong. So answer is A, that is 1 and 3. So Kishanganga project is designed to divert water from the Kishanganga River to a power plant in the Jhelum River basin. And in this, Indira Sagar Polavaram is an interstate project on the river Godavari. So that is why answer is A here. And last question for the day is, which of the following statements on Technology Acquisition and Development Fund is correct? So it has been introduced under the National Manufacturing Policy. So this statement is 100% correct, and it will facilitate MSME. That is okay. So what is the full form of MSME? So just write it in the comment section below, to acquire efficient green technologies. Which of the following statement is correct? Both these statements are correct. So TADF has been launched under the National Manufacturing Policy, NMP 2011, and Union Ministry of Commerce and Industry is responsible for the fund, and it will facilitate acquisition of clean and energy efficient technologies in form of technology, customized products, specialized services, patents, industrial design available in India or globally by micro, small and medium enterprises, MSMEs. So thank you for watching this. Have an awesome day. Hey guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs based on the 11th March 2017 current affairs, and they are presented by me, Roman Saini. So let's get started. Instructions are pretty clear, so you can follow them. Question number 1, arrange the following peninsular hill ranges in south to north direction. So here the Cardamom Hills are the southernmost, then you have Nilgiri Hills, then you have Nallamalai Hills, and then you have Balaghat Range. So Balaghat Range is in Maharashtra and that region. So answer here is C, that is 2, 3, 1 and 4. So here you can see Cardamom Hills are somewhere here at the junction of Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Nilgiri Hills as very famous, like then you have Nallamalai Hills, and then you have Balaghat Range. So this is the south to north order. Okay, so answer is C. Question number 2, which of the following statements on Sashastra Seema Bal is or are correct? Okay, let us see. It is one of India's CAPF, that is Central Armed Police Force. Everybody knows it. Yes, its mandate is to guard Indo-Nepal and Indo-Bhutan borders. Yes, both of them are correct. Answer is C. So both these statements are correct, and like every CAPF, Sashastra Seema Bal is under the administrative control of Ministry of Home Affairs. And apart from Indo-Nepal and Indo-Bhutan borders, SSB is also deployed in Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh for associate NCC officers duties, and in J&K for counter insurgency operations. So answer is C, both 1 and 2. Question number 3, which of the following statements on Saraswati Samman is correct? Samman means honor. Okay, so it is awarded to outstanding prose or poetry, literary work in Sanskrit. No, this is wrong. It is awarded to people for their contribution in the field of education. This is also wrong. It is awarded to outstanding prose or poetry, literature works in any of the 22 scheduled languages listed in Schedule 8 of the Constitution. This is correct. It is nothing to do with Sanskrit or education. Answer is C. So Saraswati Samman was instituted in 1991 by the KK Birla Foundation,
and Mahabaleshwar Sale has been honored with the Saraswati Samman 2016 for his novel Hathan in Konkani language. Question number four, consider the following statements on Chief Election Commissioner of India. So he is appointed by the President of India. Yes, this is correct. He does not hold his office till the pleasure of the President. This is also correct. In his case, it is not the same. So answer is both 1 and 2. So Chief Election Commissioner can be removed only on the same manner and the same grounds as a judge of the Supreme Court. So the answer B is also option is correct. And he can be removed by President on the basis of a resolution passed to that effect by both the Houses of Parliament with a special majority as per Article 368 of the Constitution, either on the grounds of proved misbehavior or the incapacity. So it is special majority. Special majority is very different from simple majority. Question number 5. Consider the following statements on Central Water Commission. It is an independent body of arbitration with quasi-judicial powers. It coordinates schemes for control, conservation and utilization of water resources throughout the country with consultation with the concerned state government. Which of the following statement is correct? So statement 1 is incorrect here. It is just a technical institution in the field of water resources and it is associated with Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. So this is absolutely wrong. Second statement is correct. So answer is B, that is 2 only. So, it is entrusted with general responsibility of initiating, coordinating and furthering in consultation of the state governments concerned schemes for control, conservation and utilization of water resources throughout the country for purpose of flood control, irrigation, navigation, drinking water supply and water power development. Question number 6. Which of the following pairs are correctly matched? So, Punjab Hills is in Indus-Satluj regions. Yes, 100% correct. Kumaon Hills are in Bias-Satluj region. No, they are between Satluj and Kali. So this is wrong. Nepal Hills in Kali Tista region, this is correct. Assam Hills in Tista Brahmaputra region, this is also correct. So answer is C, 134. So as I was saying, Kumaon Hills region is generally marked between the rivers of Satluj and Kali, roughly extending for 320 kilometers. Question number 7, consider the following statements on Attorney General of India. He is the highest law officer in India and appears on behalf of Government of India in all Supreme Court cases in case of Government of India is concerned. This is 100% correct. He is appointed by the Chief Justice of India. No. He is appointed by the President of India and he works in the pleasure of the President. Answer is A, 1 only. So statement 2 is incorrect because Attorney General of India is appointed by the President of India, holds office during the pleasure of the President. Question number 8. Consider the following statements on Maternity Benefit Amendment Bill of 2016. As per the bill, the revised maternity benefits are applicable to all the working women in the country and women are entitled to paid maternity leave of 26 weeks applicable to establishments with 10 or more workers in the organized sector. Which of the following statement is correct? So statement 1 is incorrect here. So as the revised maternity benefits are not applicable to those women employed in the unorganized sector, it is not applicable to all. And as I have already spoken, all extreme these positions should be avoided. And in the organized sector, over 18 lakh women are likely to be benefited by the new bill. Question number 9. Which of the following security forces are categorized under CAPF administered by the Union Government? So, Indo-Tibetan Border Police is definitely a CAPF. Then other CAPF include Border Security Force, Central Reserve Police Force, Central Industrial Security Force, Indo-Tibetan Border Police, Sashastra Seema Bal. NSG and Assam Rifles, they come under the administration of Ministry of Home Affairs. They are not CAPF. And RPF is All India Security Force. And you get admission through Civil Services Examination, through which you get IAS, IPS, you also get RPF. So answer here is A, that is 1 only. So Central Armed Police Forces is a uniform nomenclature consisting of only 5 security force. Please remember them, they can be asked. BSF, CRPF, CISF, ITBB and SSB. Border Security Force, Central Reserve Police Force, Central Industrial Security Force, Indo-Tibetan Border Police and Sashastra Seema Bal. NSG and Assam Rifles come under the administration of Ministry of Home Affairs, but they are not categorized under CAPF. And Railway Protection Force is an All India Security Force under the authority of Ministry of Railways. Last question for the day is, which of the following statements on National Hydrology Projects is or are correct? It is a central sector scheme. Yes. It is intended for setting up of a system for timely and reliable water resources, data acquisition, storage, collection and management. This is also correct. Both these statements are correct. Answer is C, 1 and 2. So National Hydrology Project provides for establishment of National Water Informatics Center as an independent organization. And impacts of the project include development of real-time flood forecasting and reservoir operations, integrated water resource management by adopting river basin approach through collation and management of hydrometeorological data, providing real-time information on a dynamic basis to the farmers about the groundwater position for them to accordingly plan their cropping patterns, promoting efficient and equitable use of water, particularly of groundwater at the village level, and provide information on quality of water. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day. Hey guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs based on the current affairs of 12th March 2017. And this is presented by me, Roman Saini. Instructions are pretty clear, so you can follow them here. No need to worry. So let's get started. Question number 1. Consider the following statements on Tipu Sultan. He planted a tree of liberty at Srirangapatnam. He set up trading companies on European lines and sent emissaries to foreign nations to develop trade. Both of them are absolutely correct. He renovated the Sringeri temple which was looted by Marathas in 1791. This is also correct. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3. All of them are correct. So all these statements are correct regarding Tipu Sultan. So if you are asked to write a short note, you can use these points. Question number 2. Which of the following statements on Jan Sankhya Sthirta Kosh, National Population Stabilization Fund are correct? It is an autonomous society of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare that can take all the policy decisions and raise contributions to support population stabilization. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Santushti and Prerna are the names of Jan Sankhya Sthirta Kosh, two primary strategic schemes. This is also correct. Answer is C, 1 and 2. So let us discuss what it is. So National Population Stabilization Fund was set up in 2004-05 with a one-time grant of rupees 100 crore in the form of a corpus fund, and JSK has been established as an autonomous body registered under the Societies Registration Act 1860 to empower NPSF. Now, Prerana strategy recognizes and awards couples who have broken the stereotype of early marriage and early childbirth and help change mindsets, while Santushti strategy involves private sector gynecologists and vasectomy surgeons to conduct operations in PPP mode. Question number 3. Which of the following statements on Great Barrier Reef off the coast of Australia is correct? It is experiencing mass coral bleaching. Coral bleaching means death of corals, loss of color as an effect of larger climate change. 100% correct. It is located in the coral sea in the northeastern coast of Australia. This is also 100% correct. It is a World Heritage Site. This is also 100% correct. Answer is D, all of the above. So if this is Australia's map, it is somewhere located here. Okay. So all the three statements are correct regarding coral bleaching. Please read more about it. Consider the following statements on uniting for consensus movement in the United Nations Security Council. It opposes the possible expansion of permanent seats in UNSC. Pakistan is a member of UFC movement. Select the correct statement using the code below. So here both these statements are again correct. So called informally as the Coffee Club, the Uniting for Consensus started in 1990s under the leadership of Italy, and it aims to counter the bids for permanent seat in UNSC proposed by G4 nations including Brazil, Germany, India and Japan. So that is why it is important for you to understand this. Question number 5. Consider the following statements on NASA's Europa Clipper mission. So it is an upcoming mission to probe the habitability of Mars moon, the Europa. Okay, Europa is not the moon of Mars. Mars has two moons, Phobos and Deimos. Europa is moon of Jupiter, I think, yes. Europa holds a salty liquid water ocean beneath its icy crust. This is correct. So if you watch any NASA documentary on Europa, you'll get to know. So answer is B2 only. So Europa is an icy moon of the Jupiter, and it was planned for launch in 2020. The Europa Clipper mission will probe the habitability of the moon by investigating its composition and structure of its interior and icy shell. So it has ocean-like conditions beneath its icy shell. Question number 6. Which of the following pairs are correctly matched? So in this case, Dhuadhar Falls are in Narmada. Yes, this is correct. Chitrakoot Falls in Indravati. This is also correct. Shivan Sundar Samudra Falls in Tungbhadra. This is wrong. And Dudh Sagar Falls in Mandovi. This is correct. Answer is D, 1, 2, 4. So Shivan Samudra Falls is located on the Kaveri River in the state of Karnataka. So that is why answer is 1, 2, 4. Consider the following statements on National Crime Records Bureau of India. It empowers Indian police with information technology solutions and criminal intelligence to enable them to enforce the law effectively. Yes, this is correct. It obtains and publishes the National Crime Statistics. This is also correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So both these statements are correct here. And National Crime Records Bureau was established in 1986 under the aegis of Ministry of Home Affairs under Government of India, and it prepares an enabling IT environment and national databases on crimes and criminals for police forces across the nation. Question number 8. Consider the following statements on National Archives of India. It is a place just located bang opposite India Gate. Okay. It is a repository of the non-current records of Government of India used for administrative and academic purposes. This is correct. It is under the aegis of Ministry of Home Affairs. No. This is under Ministry of Culture. Answer is A1 only. So statement 2 is incorrect, as the National Archives of India functions as an attached office of the Department of Culture under the Ministry of Culture. Question number 9. Which of the following islands are administered by India? Kachchatheevu is administered by Sri Lanka. By 1974, a conditional agreement was signed between India and Sri Lanka where we gave away Kachchatheevu to Sri Lanka. First is definitely wrong. So C and D cannot be the answer. Great Nicobar, obviously it's R by Minicoy Island. Obviously it is part of the Lakshadweep Island series. Koko Island is not administered by us. Answer is 2 and 3B. So Kachchatheevu, located in the Park Bay, is administered by Sri Lanka. And previously it was held by India. And then a 1974 conditional agreement was signed between India and Sri Lanka. So in that case, Kachchatheevu was given to Sri Lanka. And we recognized formally that Kachchatheevu is like ownership of the island. So that is why Indian government can transfer the territory. For example, if India want to give any state to any other nation, you can do it very well. It can be done. Any part of any state can be given to any other country. Obviously, we don't do it that much, but it can be done under parliament if parliament wants to do that. Koko Island is located in the northern side of North Andaman Island. It is administered by Myanmar. So it is not there. Minicoy Island, Lakadive Islands, they are all Lakshadweep. And last question for the day is, which of the following statements on Mekong Ganga cooperation is or are correct? So it is a bilateral initiative between India and Myanmar. First of all, it is wrong. There are 5 countries apart from India. They include Thailand, Myanmar, Cambodia, Laos and Vietnam. All these 5 are Southeast Asian nations. So the first statement is wrong. It emphasizes cooperation in tourism, culture, education, transportation, linkages among the member countries. So this statement is correct. Obviously, it makes sense. It is a logical statement. So answer is B2 only. So statement 1 is incorrect, and Mekong Ganga cooperation comprises of India and 5 Southeast Asian nations of Thailand, Myanmar, Cambodia, Laos and Vietnam. And it was established in 2000 at Vientiane, Laos at its first MGC ministerial meeting. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day. Hey guys, what's up? So today we're going to discuss about the MCQs based on 13th March 2017 current affairs. And these are presented by me, Roman Saini. So let's get started. Instructions are pretty clear, you can follow them here. And question number 1, consider the following statements on ancient seaport and urban center, Muziris. It was located on the Malabar coast in the present day state of Kerala. Okay, this is correct. It was a well-known hub of international trade with the ancient empires of Persia, Greece and Roman Empire. This is also correct. It finds frequent mention in Sangam literature. This is also correct. So answer is D123. So Muziris is an important concept which you should know about. And all these statements are correct here. So Muziris is as old as 3000 BC. So Muziris is as old as 3000 BC, and although available literary evidence suggests that it dates back to 1st century BC. And it was key to the trade of spices, precious stones among others between South India and Persians, Egyptians, Greek and Roman Empire. Question number 2, which of the following statements on United Nations Population Fund is or are correct? So here it is a UN agency that works on the field of sexual and reproductive health and rights. Yes, this is correct. And it is guided by the 1994 Program of Action of the International Conference on Population and Development. This is also correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So UNFPA works in more than 150 countries and territories that are home to the vast majority of the world's people. And its mission is to ensure that every pregnancy is wanted, every childbirth is safe, and every young person's potential is fulfilled. So answer is C, both 1 and 2. Question number 3, which of the following is not a byproduct of crude oil refining? So lubricating oil is yes, liquefied natural gas is also, paraffin wax is also, but coke is obtained from coal. It is not obtained from crude oil refining. A, B and D are obtained from crude oil refining. Answer is C. So coke is traditionally derived from coal with high carbon content, and although man-made coke known as petroleum coke or pet coke, it is derived from oil refinery coker units or other cracking process. It is also widely used, but coke is traditionally derived from coal.
So anywhere rest of the three are definitely product of refining. Question number 4. Consider the following statements on Sukanya Samriddhi account SSA. The scheme aims at achieving financial security and financial dependence to girls, children and women. Yes, both public and private sector banks as well as post office offer the facility for opening SSA account. Yes, both are correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So both these statements are correct. Sukanya Samriddhi account can be opened at any post office and public or private sector banks in the country. And it can be availed for any girl child who is 10 years old or less. And money which is saved via this scheme is to provide for higher education of girl and for her wedding expenses. The maturity period of the account is 21 years. So you have to keep this in mind as well. Question number 5. Consider the following statements on Chandrayaan 1 mission. Okay. So it aimed at employing a rover on the surface of the moon. Okay, this is wrong. It is a lunar orbiter and impactor only and not a rover. So this statement is wrong. The project involved chemical and mineralogical mapping of the entire lunar surface at high spatial resolution. This is correct. So answer is B, that is 2 only. So as I was saying, Chandrayaan 1 mission involved a lunar orbiter and an impactor, not a rover. And the mission involved chemical and mineralogical mapping of the entire lunar surface at high spatial resolution, especially elements like magnesium, aluminium, silicon, calcium, iron, titanium, radon, uranium and thorium. Let us move forward. Question number 6. Consider the following statements on Africa's Sahel region. Which of the following is correct? So it is a biogeographical region of transition between Sahara Desert and Savannah. 100% correct. Niger River flows through this region. This is also correct. Nigeria, Burkina Faso, Ghana, Chad, Niger, Nigeria, Sudan. These are the countries which lies in the Sahel region. So I'll show you now. So this is called as the Sahara Desert. This is the Savannah. This region which is called as the Sub-Saharan Africa, it is also called as Sahel. The Sahel is the eco-climatic and biogeographical zone or transition in Africa between the Sahara to the north and the Sudanian savanna to the south. It has a semi-arid climate and this zone is very prone to deforestation and desertification. Question number 7. Which of the following organizations are included in the World Bank Group? So, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. This is traditionally known as World Bank. International Development Association. This is also part of World Bank Group. IFC is also part of World Bank Group. And MIGA is also part of World Bank Group. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3, 4. All the following are correct. So, all the four institutions are part of the World Bank Group. Question number 8. Consider the following statements on Index of Industrial Production, IIP. So, it is compiled and published by CSO on monthly basis. It measures the short-term changes in the volume of production of a basket of industrial products during a given period with respect to that in a chosen base period. Which of the following statement is correct? So yes, it is compiled by CSO on monthly basis, so this is correct. And yes, it measures the short-term changes in the volume of production during a given period with respect to a chosen base period. So every index does that. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So 8 core industries comprising nearly 38% of the weight of items including in the IIP. So it is important. Question number 9. Which of the following are the fundamental principles of Panchsheel? So which of the following are fundamental principles of Panchsheel? Non-alignment is not a fundamental principle of Panchsheel. Peaceful coexistence is yes there. Mutual respect for each other's territory. Mutual non-aggression is also there. Answer is D, that is 2, 3, 4. Then you have peaceful coexistence. And you have equality and cooperation for mutual benefit. So I'll tell you the 5 principles now. So the major 5 principles of Panchsheel. Basically this agreement was signed between Indochina and during 1950s between Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and China. So they said that these 5 agreements will be there. Mutual respect for each other's territorial integrity, mutual non-aggression, mutual non-interference in each other's internal affairs, equality and cooperation for mutual benefit and peaceful coexistence. So these are the major 5 principles of Panchsheel. Now last question for the day is, which of the following statements on Chabahar port is or are correct? It is located in the Arabian Sea coast of Pakistan and is a part of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, that is CPEC. And proposals have been made to integrate Chabahar port with the International North-South Transport Corridor. Which of the following statement is correct? So the statement first is wrong because Chabahar port is located in Iran on the Gulf of Oman. This is wrong. And second statement is correct. So answer is B, that is 2 only. So Chabahar port is located in Iran on the Gulf of Oman. And India and Iran have a long standing agreement which was signed in 2002 to develop Chabahar port into the full deep sea port. and India has a strategic interest over the port. It has long-term plans to integrate Chabahar with the international north-south transport corridor so that we can have seamless trade to Europe and other countries. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day.
Guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs today, and they will be based on the 14th March 2017 current affairs, and obviously they are presented by me, Roman Seni. Instructions are pretty clear, so let's get started. Question number 1, consider the following statements on butterfly. They are considered as key indicators of the health of local ecosystem. 100% correct. They have short life cycles and thus react to environmental changes very quickly. This is also 100% correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So butterflies are increasingly being recognized as valuable environmental indicators, both for their rapid and sensitive responses to subtle habitat or climatic changes, and as representatives for the diversity and responses of other wildlife. And as you might know, that insects constitute more than 50% of all the terrestrial wildlife species, and therefore it is crucial to assess the fate of insect groups in order to monitor the overall state of biodiversity. Insects are they have the most number of species on this planet Earth in all the animals. Question number 2, which of the following statements on endosulfan is or are correct? It is a widely banned pesticide with hazardous effects on human genetic and endocrine system. 100% correct. India is a signatory to the Stockholm Convention of 2011 that negotiated a global ban on the manufacture and use of endosulfan. Which of the following statement is correct? Here, the answer is C, that both the statement is correct. Endosulfan is known for its neurotoxicity, bioaccumulation and endocrine disruption. Bioaccumulation means that it gets accumulated in the live tissues, and biomagnification means that its concentration increases as you go up the chain. So DDT increases in the birds, and that's why their shells break. And it was spread on cashew nuts, cotton, fruits. Kasargod district of Kerala is very famous for endosulfan related issues. Tea, paddy, tobacco for control of pests, including white flies, aphids, beetles, worms, etc. Question number 3, anti-helminthic drugs are used for which of the following? So basically anti-helminthic drugs, they are anti-parasites, so obviously they are used for parasites. Helminths are the roundworms, okay, they are the worms, okay. So anti-helminthics are the medications which are used to eradicate parasitic worms, helminths from the human body. And there is a national deworming, it's usually used in children because they have a lot of worms inside their belly. And albendazole tablets are commonly used, and they reduce the burden of parasitic worms in the community. So they are used by the PSM departments. It is used as an anti-helminthic drug. Question number 4, consider the following statements on UNCLOS, that is United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea. It defines the rights and responsibilities of nation with respect to the uses of the world's oceans and its marine natural resources. And India is a party to the UNCLOS, that is United Nations Convention on the Law of the Seas. Which of the following statement is correct? Yes, India is a party to UNCLOS. Yes, it defines the rights and responsibility of nation. Answer is C, that is 1 and 2 here. Okay. So solution is C here, and both the statements are correct. The Commission of Legal Continental Shelf, to which India has decided not to field a candidate for the scientific body's upcoming election, is part of the UNCLOS. And Commission of Legal Continental Shelf is a 21-person body that decides what portion of the seabed can be exclusively mined for natural resources such as oil, precious metals and minerals. So answer is C. Question number 5, consider the following statements on Srinagar-Jammu National Highway. So it is a part of India's longest national highway. Yes, it is part of the India's longest national highway, which runs from Srinagar to Kanyakumari, and it is NH-44. And India's longest road tunnel is being constructed in this highway section. This is also correct. This is called as Patni Top Tunnel. So answer is C here, that is both 1 and 2 are correct. So Srinagar-Jammu National Highway is a part of NH-44 that runs from Srinagar to Kanyakumari. And Patni Top Tunnel, it is also known as the Chenani Nashri Tunnel. And it is a road tunnel under construction in this section, which is the longest of 9.2 km of its kind in India. Question number 6, there exists a close parallelism between the latitudinal zonation and altitudinal zonation of biomes. This is correct. Mount Kenya and Mount Chimborazo are exceptions to the parallelism between latitudinal and altitudinal zonation of biomes. This is wrong. This is absolutely wrong, because despite being on equator, their top is covered by ice cap. So that is the exact example of parallelism between latitude and altitude. So answer is answer is A, that is one only, because second statement is wrong. So as I was saying, the both have the ice capped peaks at Mount Kenya and Mount Chimborazo,
which are located close to equator are perfect examples to the parallelism between latitudinal and altitudinal zonation of biomes. Question number 7, consider the following statements regarding Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi, RAN. So, it aims to provide financial assistance to patients living below poverty line and suffering from major life-threatening diseases. So, this is correct. The financial assistance is released in form of direct benefit transfer to the patient. This is wrong. It is given as a one-time grant. Okay, that is wrong. The answer is A only, 1. So, statement 2 is incorrect as the scheme involves disbursal of financial assistance to patients through one-time grant. And Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi, RAN, was formerly known as National Illness Assistance Fund. And it covers the treatment for life-threatening diseases and ailments at any government hospital. And diseases of common nature and diseases for which treatment is available free of cost under other health scheme program are not eligible for grants under RAN. So it is a common sense. If you are already covered, then why will it cover here? Question number 8, which of the following is correctly matched? So if you see, ISO height means it is related to annual rainfall. It is not related to sunshine. This is wrong. And ISO health is related to sunshine and it is not related to annual rainfall. So first is fourth, fourth is one. Second is 100% correct. Bar means pressure, so equal atmospheric pressure. Therm means temperature, so equal thermal temperature. Answer is A, that is 2 and 3. 1 and 4 are cross matched. So ISO height refers to a line on map connecting points having the same mean annual rainfall, while ISO health on the other hand refers to a line on a map connecting points having equal sunshine distribution. Question number 9, which of the following are compiled by the Central Statistical Office, CSO? So, National Accounts Index of Industrial Production, Consumer Prices Index, all the three are basically compiled by the Central Statistical Office, CSO. So, answer is D, 1, 2, 3. So, Central Statistical Office is responsible for coordination of statistical activities in the country and for evolving and maintaining statistical standards. And its activities includes compilation of national accounts, conduction of annual survey of industries and economic censuses, and compilation of index of industrial production and consumer price indexes. Very, very important. CSO short note can be asked. Please remember everything from it. Last question for the day is, which of the following statements is correct on Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana? It is implemented through PPP. 100% correct. It is implemented through National Skill Development Corporation. This is also correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas. Kaushal Vikas means, Kaushal means skill, Vikas means development, Pradhan Mantri means Prime Minister, Yojana means scheme. It aims to offer 24 lakh Indian youth meaningful, industry relevant and skill based training, and it is approved for another 4 years to benefit 10 million youth. And the National Skill Qualification Framework and industry defined standards will be fundamental to the skill development, and under this scheme the trainees will be offered a financial reward and a certification on successful completion of training and assessment, which will help them in securing a job for a better future. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day. Hey guys, what's up? So let us discuss the MCQs based on 15th March 2017 current affairs, and this is presented by me, Roman Saini. So instructions are pretty clear. You can watch the Hindu summary editorial analysis here before or after attempting the questions, and as soon as the question appears, please pause the video and answer the question and resume it. Question number 1, consider the following statements on Interstate River Water Disputes Amendment Bill of 2017. So it proposed a single standing tribunal with multiple benches for all interstate river water disputes instead of existing multiple tribunals. Yes, as per the bill, a dispute resolution committee DRC will be established by the central government before any interstate whatever water dispute is referred to the tribunal. So both these options are correct. Answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So the Interstate River Water Dispute Amendment Bill of 2017, it was introduced in the Lok Sabha on 14th March of this month. So today is 15th. And it proposes to streamline the adjudication of interstate river water disputes and make the present legal and institutional architecture under Interstate Water Dispute Act of 1956 robust and transparent. So it is very important for you to get this straight. Okay. Then question number 2, which of the following statements on Thane Creek is or are correct? The area along the western bank of Thane Creek has been declared as a flamingo sanctuary. Okay, statement 2 is Jawaharlal Nehru Port is accessed via Thane Creek. So yes, both of the statements are again correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So both these statements are correct, so you should know about these things. Madhukar Gupta committee that was recently on the news is related to which of the following? So it is basically to strengthen border protection and addressing various vulnerabilities in fencing along the Indo-Pakistan border. This was related to Madhukar Gupta committee. So the committee constituted under the chairmanship of Shri Madhukar Gupta, he gave recommendation to the government of India on the issues of threats and border protection, assessment of force level deployment on the border, infrastructure and technology issues for protection of border and administrative issues. So here the answer is C. Question number 4, consider the following statements on gravitational forces of the earth. These forces are greater near the poles and less at the equator, and the difference in gravity values gives clues on the distribution of material in the earth's crust. So which of the following statement is correct? Here both of these statements are correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. So the greater the distance from the center of earth at equator than at poles, and it is attributed for the relatively less gravity values at the equator. So here both these statements are correct. So these are the basic questions. If you read NCERTs properly, then you will get them correct. Answer is C, both 1 and 2. Question number 5, consider the following statements. Okay, Goa is the first state to achieve 100% primary education. Okay, this is wrong. Kerala is the first state to achieve total primary education. This is 100% wrong. Second statement is Telangana is the first state to make gender education compulsory in schools. Yes, this is correct. Answer is B, that is 2 only. So as I was saying, Kerala is the first state in India to achieve total primary education. And it is important to recollect the state government's Athulyam program aimed at ensuring total primary education equivalent to standard 4 of formal education. So this was it. Then question number 6, consider the following statements on Shanghai Cooperation Organization. So it is considered as a countermeasure to the growing influence of North Atlantic Treaty Organization NATO. And both India and Pakistan have signed memorandum of obligation to join SCO as members. Which of the following statement is correct? Here answer is C, both 1 and 2. Both these statements are absolutely correct. And both India and Pakistan signed the memorandum of obligation last year at Tashkent, Uzbekistan to join SCO as full-fledged members. So here answer is C. Question number 7. Consider the following statements regarding National Agricultural Fair Krishi Unnati Mela. Krishi means farming. Unnati means like promotion or development or anything related to development. Mela means fair 2017. So it is being organized as part of Make in India program. Okay, so this is organized by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So this is wrong. And it is expected to benefit the farming community and all stakeholders of agricultural development by enabling a platform for agri products, technology and services. This is correct. Answer is B, 2 only. So statement 1 is incorrect, as the Krishi Unnati Mela 2017 is being organized by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and FICCI is the project management partner for the fair, and the fair will feature live crop demonstration, protected cultivation of vegetable and flowers, display of cut flowers, exotic vegetables and fruits, sale of seeds of high yielding varieties, and interface of the farmers with agro industries personnel. Question number 8, which of the following pairs are correctly matched? So they are like very very famous islands. Galapagos Island, everybody should know, Charles Darwin went there. It is in Ecuador, so this is wrong. Easter Island is in Chile, so first and second are wrong. If you can see, first and second are wrong, then the only option that can be correct is C. So anybody who knows Galapagos Island, it is just next to Ecuador. If you just know that Galapagos Island are in Ecuador, then A is eliminated, B is eliminated, D is eliminated. The only option that can be correct is here. So this C, 3 only. So sorry for this A. So Galapagos Island is in Ecuador, Easter Island is in Chile, Canary Island is in Spain. Okay. So 9th question, which of the following statements on Saturn's largest moon Titan is or are correct? It is claimed as the only moon in the solar system that has a thick nitrogen rich atmosphere. It is claimed to receive hydrocarbon rain composed of liquid ethane and methane, and NASA's Cassini's Huygens mission is one of the primary source of information on Titan. So here all the statements are correct, that is D, 1, 2, 3. So the Mercury sized Titan, it is Saturn's largest moon, and it features lakes that receive hydrocarbon rain composed of liquid ethane and methane, which are considered the building blocks of life. So people think that there might be life here. And the last question for the day is, which of the following statements on CBI is or are correct? It was established on the recommendation of Swan Singh Committee. No, our fundamental duties were established on recommendation of Swan Singh Committee. It was established on Santhanam Committee on Prevention of Corruption. It's recommendation. It derives its power from the Central Reserve Police Force Act of 1949. It derives its power from Delhi Special Police Establishment Act of 1946. Why will it derive from CRPF? It does not make even any sense. So here answer is D, none of the above. Yes. So both these statements are incorrect. Santhanam Committee on Prevention of Corruption is from 1962 to 1964, and they recommended the establishment of CVC, Central Vigilance Commission. Now, on the other hand, Swarn Singh Committee recommended addition of fundamental duties to the Indian Constitution, and CBI was established in 1963, deriving its power from the Delhi Special Police Establishment Act of 1946. So, thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day.